After 3 days stranded in the Atlantic, two men are back on dry land tonight. They started out in the Keys on Saturday with a 41-foot boat, but ended up in Boca Raton this morning on a 9-foot dinghy.
Angela Rozier has more on their incredible journey and the surprising thing one of the men did once back on shore.
Michael Ayers is glad to be alive. So glad he asked his girlfriend of 3 years to marry him.
He said, I'm here, I'm alive, and we're getting married.
He and his shipmate were stranded out at sea for 3 days.
We rode and rode and rode, and somehow miraculously made it back to Florida from out in the Atlantic.
Ayers says the ordeal started Saturday. He and his shipmate took off from the Key Largo area, heading to Bimini in his 1963 41-foot Hatteras. A few hours into their trip, Ayers says they hit some debris and the boat started taking on water. They grabbed some provisions, got into the small dinghy, and tried to keep warm. His friends and girlfriend were worried.
I'd been on the phone with the Coast Guard, but they had no distress signals. They didn't receive any, nobody. But I knew he had lots of flares, and I knew he was really good on the water, being brought up on the Great Lakes. I didn't feel like he was gone, but I cried a lot because I thought he was cold.
After 3 days of rowing, the two ended up here in Boca Raton, tired and dehydrated.
Certainly, we don't see this every day, so I don't have a lot of cases to gauge this against. But they look pretty good, all things said.
I'm just so grateful to be here and be alive. I can't express it to you in words, almost. But I can just say that, for the record, it was one heck of a boat ride.
And I asked Michael if he had any plans on getting back on a boat. He says not right now. He does plan to spend more time with his family and his fiancée. In Boca Raton, Angela Rozier, WPBF 25.